Because the baker had lost his mother and father in a baking accident. Or at least that's what he believed. He was eager to have a family of his own, and was concerned that all efforts until now had failed.
Who might that be?
So bad, that's not for Fred.
It's the witch from next door.
We have no bread!
Of course you have no bread!
What do you wish?
Oh, it's not what I wish. It's what you wish. Nothing cooking in there now, is there?
The old enchantress went on to tell the couple that she had placed a spell on their house.
What spell?
In the past, when you were no more than a babe, your father brought his young wife and you to this cottage. They were a handsome couple, but not handsome neighbors. You see, your mother was a child, and she developed an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden and told your father that what she wanted more than anything in the world was greens. Greens and nothing but greens. Parsley, peppers, cabbage isn't celery, asparagus and watercress and millwort and lettuce. He said, all right. But it wasn't quite, because I caught him in the autumn in my garden one day. He was roaring me, raping me, rooting through my rutabaga, braiding my own blood, ripping up the rail in my chest with my fingers. I should have made a spell on him right there. Could have turned them into stone. Nah, but I let him have the rapine I'd lost to spare. In return, however, I said fair is fair. You can let me have the baby that your wife will wear. I will call it square.
I had a brother?
No! But you had a sister.
But the witch refused to tell him anything more of his sister. Not even that her name was Rapunzel. She went on.
I thought I had been more than reasonable, and that we all might live happily ever after. But how was I to know what your father had also hidden in his pocket? You see, when I inherited that garden, my mother had warned me I would be punished if I were ever to lose any of the beans.
Beans?
The special beans! I let him go. I didn't know he'd stolen my beans. I was watching him crawl back over the wall, then bang! Crash in the lightning flash! Well, that's another story. Never mind. Anyway, at last the big day came, and I made my claim. Oh, I'll take away the bean! He shrieked and screeched, but I did, and I hid her where she'll never be reached. And your father cried, and your mother died. But for extra measure, I admit it was a pleasure. I said, sorry, I'm still not qualified. And I made a little spell on them. You too, son. That your family tree would always be a barren one. So, there is no more fuss, and there's no more seeds, and my garden thrives.